Hey everyone, if you want to track the traffic on our website, there is a tool called Google Analytics. With the help of Google Analytics, we can track the visitors on our website, for how much duration they are staying on our website, what pages they are seeing, how much time they are spending on a particular page, from which city the traffic is coming in, from which country the traffic is coming in, or let's say, from which source the traffic is coming in, whether it's coming from Facebook or, you know, Google or through your email marketing or any other source. So in this video, we will see how we can install Google Analytics on your WordPress website. So first of all, you have to go to a website, analytics.google.com. Once you are on this web page, click Start Measuring. Now, I am already logged in with my Gmail account. If you don't have a Gmail account, you can create a Gmail account for free. Or if you have your own existing Gmail account, then you can use the same credentials to log into analytics.google.com. Now, let's say once I start click measuring, I'll have to create an account. So let's say the account name is, Prathamesh. Then we have to agree to bunch of terms and conditions. Then click next. Now it will ask us what exactly we want to measure, whether we want to measure the traffic on the website, whether we want to measure, you know, apps, the insights of the apps, or we want to measure both. So for now, we want to select web because basically we are tracking a WordPress website. So go select web and click next. Now here I have to enter my website name. Now what I have created first is an account. Now one account can have multiple websites. So let's say I want to install Google Analytics on my website, which is a two-stage funnel WordPress website. So let me type the name two-stage funnel. In the next box, I have to type my URL. Now, whether you are using SSL or not, depending upon that, select either HTTP or HTTPS. If you are using SSL, then go ahead with HTTPS. If you are not using SSL, go with HTTP. Now, my website here is secure, hence it is using HTTPS. So what I have to do, I have to just copy the URL of my website and paste it here. Now, since my website is secure, I'll select HTTPS. Now, I have to select an industry category. So, let me select one. Let me just go with, you know, other. Now, depending upon your time zone, select appropriate time zone. Now, since I'm in India, I'll select India, Indian Standard Time. Okay, I'll to select the country first. Okay, India, and it automatically selected India GMT 530. So let me click create. Now again, I have to accept bunch of terms and conditions. So accept. I'll just click here. No thanks for now. Okay, so I have got my tracking ID now. Google has given us with a tracking script as well, which I have to install on my WordPress website. Unless and until we install this tracking script, we can't, you know, measure the performance of our website in terms of traffic. So how should we install this script on our WordPress website? For that, go to your WordPress backend and, you know, go to plugins and add a new plugin. So here I'll add one plugin. It's called Analytify. So this is the plugin that I want to install. Google Analytics dashboard plugin for WordPress by Analytify. So let me just click install now. Activate it. Once the plugin is activated, it will show you one notice: connect Analytify with your Google account. So let me click connect here. Okay, now you can click skip this step here. In the next step, I have to click on login with your Google Analytics account. So now I log in with my Gmail ID. So let me just click my account here. Click allow. And then I am returned to the WordPress dashboard. And the message is, congratulations, Analytify is now authenticated. Please select your website profile here and get started. So now in this screen, there is first option, install Google Analytics tracking code. Now toggle this to yes. If you select no, you actually have to, you know, copy this code and paste it in your theme file or, you know, some other plugin where you can add JavaScripts. But I don't want to do that. Therefore, what I did, I toggled this to yes. Now the second option is exclude users from tracking. I have selected administrator. What does this mean? This means, let's say if you are an administrator, you are, you know, logging onto your website a lot of times in a day, and what happens is, you know, the traffic that we don't want to measure gets measured. And there is an actual traffic which is coming not from you, but from outside visitors. And that is the traffic that we want to measure and not our own traffic. Therefore, we exclude the administrators from tracking. So if I am logged into my WordPress admin, Google Analytics won't track me. And that is what we want. We don't want to, you know, get inflated number of, you know, visitors coming onto your website. Let's say if you haven't excluded yourself and you are, you know, visiting your website 10 times, then those that traffic will also be measured by Google Analytics, which is something we don't want. Now profile for posts. So here select, open this drop down and you will see two stage funnel and select all website data. Now even for, you know, profile for dashboard, you can select this one and now click save changes. Now your Google Analytics script is installed on your WordPress website. The additional feature of using this plugin is, let's say if you click on this dashboard under Analytify, you get all the, you know, statistics and how the traffic is coming onto your website kind of analytics directly in your WordPress site. Otherwise, what you have to do, you have to go to, you know, analytics.google.com and, you know, see the traffic on your website. So I have to click home here so that I can, you know, go to my actual analytics. Then I can go on clicking audience, then overview. So here I will get all the data, and same data you can see in Analytify dashboard as well. Now everything is zero because we just have installed this script and it's not tracking basically administrators. So let me just, you know, open another incognito mode. So let me just go to funnels. Let me just log out from here. Now I'm logged out. So let me just go to the home page of this website, my Google Analytics dashboard. So here, if I click on real time now and select overview, I can see that there is one user right now active on my website, and slash means root page, that is home page. So as you can see, now Google Analytics is perfectly integrated with our website. So go ahead, create your own account on analytics.google.com. Then go to your WordPress admin, install Analytify plugin and start tracking the visitors on your website. So that's it for this video. If you have any doubts, share in the comments box and I'll try to reply you. Thank you.